Hi students, welcome back. Let's continue with the software concepts of the in distributed system. So in the previous video I explained about the network operating system. Now another software concept is the distributed operating system. It is different from multiprocessor and multi-computer hardware. So whenever you are seeing the word distributed operating system, you are thinking that it may be it having a multiprocessors. Each system is capable of having the multiprocessor, or it is a multi-computer hardware, but it is not. Okay, the multiprocessor is different, multi-computer is different, and the distributed is different. Then what is a multiprocessor? The multiprocessor uses different system services to manage resource connected in a system and use the system calls to communicate with the processor. This is a multiprocessor. Means here the user uses different system services will be using. So that's why we are calling it a multiprocessor. It is going to manage resource connected in a system by using the system calls with the processor. Then what about the multi-computer? The multi-computer, the distributed operating system uses a separate uniprocessor operating system on each computer for communicating between different computers. So if you are using the distributed operating system, the distributed operating system uses a separate uniprocessor operating system, means each machine is having their own operating system. This you call it as a uni operating system. So it enables, the distributed operating system enables a distributed system to behave like a virtual uniprocessor, even though the system operates on a collection of machines. Now let's see what are the characteristics of using this distributed operating system. It enabling the inter-process communication. The distributed operating system is enabling the inter-process communication. Uniform process management mechanism is available. Uniform and visible file systems are there. Identical kernel implementation is there. Local control of machines and handling scheduling issues. So these are all the characteristics of the distributed operating system. And also it communicates with all the computers using one message, that is MPI, message passing interface. With the help of the message passing interface, the distributed operating system is going to be communicate with all the computers. And it also follows a tightly coupled architecture pattern. So whereas the network operating system is a loosely coupled architecture pattern, but the distributed operating system follows the tightly coupled. So this is the main difference between NOS and DOS. It follows the tightly coupled architecture pattern. It uses the distributed systems like queue to manage the avoid messages loss between the sender and receiver computer. So the examples for this: automated banking system, railway reservation system. So it uses the distributed system, so like a queue to manage avoid messages loss of between sender and the receiver computer. So these two technologies will use this process: automatic banking system and the railway reservation system. The disadvantages of using this distributed operating system is it has a problem of scalability, as it supports only limited number of independent computers with shared resources. So why it has a problem of scalability? Because it supports only limited number of independent computers. Not it can't have handle large computers at a time. It can support only the limited number of independent computers with the shared resources. There is need to define message passing semantics prior to the execution of message. Let's see the architecture of this distributed operating system. A machine A, machine B, machine C. So these are the independent operating systems sharing the resources like distributed applications, distributed operating system service, and each machine having is their own kernel. All systems are connected over network. So here it is having the distributed operating system services, which are shared by all machine A, machine B, and machine C. Thank you.